So listening, you know, again, some good points on, you know, as Jasmine talked about, the female athletics. Definitely, if any of you have any parents or you don't know the girls out there that are not here, let them know some of this information as well. And of course, we'll have this up on the website, that you can look at this information. You know, look at it down on the website. And get this information out to women in this county, in this area, because we want women to have just as many opportunities as guys do. For one, and two, there are definitely a lot of opportunities that are out there. Just a matter of getting the right information out there too. And you know, there are coaches, you know, like that that are here. You know, they all just don't have to be at the high school. These travel and club teams, they do a lot of work behind the scenes to set these programs up, you know, for their students and those club teams, as much as, you know, the high schools do. So let me get that information out to them. So our next speaker we're going to have is Saleem Brown. Saleem is going to come here and talk about first year experience and what to expect, whether you are an incoming freshman student or if you're a transfer student. I want to get this information out to you. So, Saleem, come on up.
First, I'd like to thank Councilman O and James Williams for allowing me to speak to you all today and allowing me to be a part of this leadership program. Just a little bit about me. I grew up in Chester, PA. Decided to attend Cabrini College as a student athlete, where I will major in business administration and minor in marketing and resource, played on the men's basketball team, and also was a student ambassador. After graduation in 2004, I received a position in the admissions office that allowed me to coach assistant men's basketball coach for the Cabrini College men's basketball team. Through that experience, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the admissions process. Working as an admissions counselor for 11 years, I helped a ton of students out either get accepted into Cabrini, which is Maine Prince University, or another institution. So I'm trying to give you some helpful tips today that you can take home with you or share with someone else that is not here about getting accepted into college. And I'm also going to talk about my current position, Associate Director of First Year Experience, and how I help incoming freshmen get acclimated in their first year to campus. Okay, so some helpful tips, as Michael talked about earlier, is selecting your school based on the location, the size, and what it has to offer you. Going to your junior and then into your senior year, you should have that narrowed down to 5 schools that you would like to visit, that you see yourself staying for the next 4 years. With those 5 schools, you need to put together a team of people around you who will help you throughout the admissions process, because it won't be easy. You know, there's deadlines that you have to meet. Your team should consist of your guidance counselor, your coach, a high school teacher, preferably someone in English, and I'll talk about that later on. With the admissions process, there are so many things that go into it. Just for instance, Cabrini College admissions process, the average GPA is a 3.1. The average SAT score is 1,000. That's math and verbal combined. Okay, that is just the average. So students are accepted at higher than average GPA and SAT score. Okay, if you don't meet the average, and I'll talk about that, what you can do to still get accepted into that school. So let's talk about the process. First and foremost, with the application, always talk to your guidance office. There can be fee waivers for an application, so you won't have to pay that application fee. Talk to your guidance counselor about that. Once you apply to your college or university of your choice, you want to then send your high school transcripts, your essay, and your recommendation letters, and also your SAT ratings in schools. As an admissions counselor, I'm going to talk about some of the things that I look at and will help you when you're sending these items in. First and foremost, when I get your transcript on my desk, I look at your attendance and your days late. Why do I look at that? Because that tells me a little bit about the student that I want to accept them into our college. If it's hard for you to attend school while you're at home, then it's going to be hard for you to attend school when you're in college, when there's no adults telling you to go to class. You're going to have other students that are your age, you know, and again, you don't have any adults around, so it's hard to go to class if someone's telling you, oh, we don't have to do that today, we don't have to go to class today, we can miss a day, it's only one class. Missing one class, from my experience in college, is almost like missing two. Coming late is almost like missing a half a class. So try not to, in high school, start that trend of missing classes and coming late to class because it's disruptive at the end of the day. Talking about your test scores, going back to your transcript, they're going to look at your GPA, and if your GPA doesn't meet their average, they're going to look at your test scores. Okay, and again, the average GPA for Cabrini College is 1,000. Other schools are 990, some might be 950. So there's different ranges for different schools. Say, for instance, you fall beneath the GPA and the SAT range. It's not over from there. There's still an opportunity to get accepted into that college or university. That's when your essay comes into play and your recommendation letters. And when I talked about getting with the English professor, making sure that essay is a really good essay, that's a snapshot of who you are. That's what the admissions council is going to read. They're going to try to figure out who are we accepting into our college or university? Who are we going to give this opportunity to? So make sure that essay is well written. You know, it has a good link to it, two, maybe three pages. In that essay, talk about all the things that you're involved in inside and outside of school. Talk about a part-time job that you have. Talk about, the community service work that you do. Put everything into that essay, because that can be a deciding factor on getting you accepted if you don't meet the SAT or GPA average, okay? Next, I'm going to talk about community service work. As I mentioned before, getting involved, whether it's in the community or the school that you attend or your neighborhood, getting involved is huge. Colleges, universities love that because it kind of says, okay, when you come to our school, you want to get involved some way, somehow, whether it's through a club organization or a community service work. And that's the kind of person you are. I talk to all our first year students about giving to someone else more than you give to yourself. And that's kind of what community service work is. Campus visit, very huge. You want to visit the campus as many times as you possibly can because that's what you want to spend at least 8 out of the next 12 months, on that college campus. So you want to make sure that campus is the one for you. You want to visit the campus. You want to see the dorm room where you'll be staying at. You want to visit the cafeteria. Make sure the food is edible to your liking. You want to make sure that, the resources, you know where they're located. How big is the classroom? Is it an auditorium size or is it a nice small size class where it fits 15 students? So that's why a campus visit is so important. And it's important because this is an opportunity to have an admissions interview with your admissions counselor. You can sit down face to face with this admissions counselor and talk about why you want to be at this school. Why is this the right choice for you? Would you see yourself going over the next 4 years at this college or university? So campus visit, please do it as many times as you can. The more you do it, the more comfortable you start to feel with that college, and that's how you know what school or what college or university is good for you. One big thing, completing the FAFSA form. Start on that FAFSA form. The government's going to change a bunch of things with the FAFSA form, but as of now, that FAFSA form can be done after January 1st. It can be estimated over last year's taxes, or you can wait until your parents get taxes from that year and complete the FAFSA form. But completing that is very, very crucial. That's where all of your money will be coming from. Make sure you get that FAFSA in before May 1st, because if you're a PA resident and you turn it in May 2nd, May 3rd, May 4th, you might miss out on a PA state grant, and from what I know right now, that could be $4,000 that you miss out on. So make sure you get that FAFSA completed. Again, if you have trouble completing that FAFSA, go talk to your guidance counselor. Talk to the financial aid counselor at that college or university that you want to attend. Have them help you out with that FAFSA, because it's so important that you fill that out. My last note as far as getting accepted into our college is making sure that you build a friendly relationship with the financial aid counselor, making sure all your documents are in, everything is good, so that way you have no trouble when it comes time to move in and start your college career. Make that financial aid officer just as important as the admissions counselor, okay? So those are a couple of helpful tips that I hope that you can either take home and use or share with someone else. Now I switch over and talk to you about your first year experience in college. I always say to students who come to campus for the first year, the most important part is get involved on campus. Whether it be through a club or organization, and if it's not one there for you, try to start one up. Because you never know on campus, there might be someone interested in music, but there might not be a music club or organization. But if you start it up, then the others will follow. So try to get involved. As a student, when I was a student at Cabrini College, I got involved. I worked for the admissions office. I was a student ambassador. I had fun giving tours and working with incoming freshmen and high school students, but it also took my mind off of athletics for a little bit, took my mind off of basketball. took my mind off the academic, because I was just a missions counselor, a student ambassador, and I was just giving information to parents and prospective students about the college, and I enjoyed that part of it. The next thing I would say is get a planner, okay? A planner is very important. You have to remain organized, especially being a student athlete. You might have practice on Monday at 6 a.m., but on Tuesday you're practicing at 8 at night. Then you have classes to go with that. Then you want to have fun with your friends in a personal life. So make sure you organize yourself. The more you're organized, the easier college will be for you. Trust me on that. Use all the available resources that are there for you. And resources I'm talking about, the Writing Center, the Math Tutoring Center, the Peer Tutors, and the one-on-one tutoring. Make sure you use those resources. Myself, I'm not a strong writer, so even my undergraduate and when I attended the master's program at Cabrini College, I still use Writing Center, because my thinking was, I know that I don't want to turn in a D or a C paper, but if I go to this Writing Center and I get this help, that C can turn into a B, B plus, or A. So use the resources. At most, all colleges and university resources are free. So definitely get in there and use all the resources that are available to you. Lastly, most importantly, find out your professor's office hours, okay? Because they can help you through so many situations. If you're struggling in the class, if you need extra credit to pass that class or get a higher grade to boost your GPA, if you're having trouble connecting with another professor in another class, they can help you out with that. So find that professor, see what office hours are, become friends with them. And I think that'll make your college experience a little bit more easier once you connect with your professors on campus, okay? And as I said before, take advantage of the financial aid office, because you have to deal with that all 4 years on campus. I know through your financial aid, your basketball, you'll also be offered things like work study, where you can get a job on campus, you can be paid for, so that way you're not always calling home asking for money, and you get a little bit of money on hand for yourself, but it also gives you a skill to work in an office which you can put on your resume. So those are few of some hopefully helpful tips to you as you begin your first year on a college campus, or you're looking to go through the admissions process. So I hope that was helpful for you all today.
Does anybody have any questions for Saleem? Anybody have questions? Yes, Curry.
Yes. It's a free application for federal student aid. I use that in FAFSA. It's a free application for you to get grant money. And when you fill that out, the school will send you back the financial aid worksheet. In the mail, and it lists all your grants and scholarships. And I think you mentioned it earlier, there's a difference between scholarships and merit scholarships, and that difference should be explained on that financial aid report that you get sent to your house. That is the difference between that's explaining that to the pre-application for federal student.
Thank you so much.